Well, it's been 6 months, I guess, since we were here last time, which has been mostly wonderful. We played in a lot of countries last year. Yeah, I made a new record called One Eye to Morocco. Well, that's the problem when we're talking literally. It's not literal at all. It doesn't mean Morocco at all. It's nothing to do with Morocco. It's a phrase that I got from Poland, and it's the full phrase is One Eye to Morocco and the other to the Caucasus. I guess it means looking cross-eyed, having two eyes in different directions. And I related that as a musical metaphor to Deep Purple being the Caucasus and Morocco being my naughty weekend away. There's a song on my new album, One Eye to Morocco, called Change My Ways. And the opening line is, when the Cold War's over, the hot one just begun. And we talk about the end of the Cold War and the beginning of global warming. The pulse of humanity means that things are changing all the time. Now we start thinking in quantum ways. We can understand that how it may sound stupid about a butterfly making a tiny movement in the Amazon forest, and suddenly there's a local war breaks out in Indonesia. The traveling is boring now. And dehumanizing, I must say. The only thing that is still interesting is the culture and the music. And so we make the most of it. And I think the greatest honor, if you go to somebody's house for the first time and spend some time with them, the greatest honor you can possibly have is to be invited back. And so we're back again. And I respect that with great humility. Well, this is a complex issue, isn't it? Religion is an environmental thing. If I was born in Mecca, it's pretty obvious that I wouldn't have grown up as a Catholic or a Buddhist. And the same goes, if you follow that line of thinking, you can reach your own assumptions. The prophets, I can think of three prophets at the moment. If you think of Christianity, Islam, and Scientology, for example, or Sikhism, where there are hundreds and hundreds of prophets and gods. But in those three that I'm talking about, you have Jesus, Muhammad, and Ron. And they have no relevance to me. I know God exists, but religion is based in historical things that have no relevance today. I don't believe there's any great creator that made the universe or anything like that. We know we've got spirituality, and we might as well call it God. And that God has been interpreted by the witch doctors since time began. And it still is. I have been had a great interest in theology and infinity since I was a child. So I think you have to understand what it is that makes up human nature. The nearest we have to understanding that are the great philosophers and, of course, Charles Darwin, who made us think about some form of evolutionary process. We've interpreted from his work the idea that you have to evolve or die, evolution, which became parodied, or paraphrased, I should say, as survival of the fittest. And survival became synonymous with evolution. Well, I think there was another chapter missing from his work, the final chapter, or maybe. And that's not survival, it's supremacy. Because supremacy is the driving force in human nature. That's why God is interpreted in different ways, in different regions of the earth. It's my version of God. It's not really, it's just a domestic interpretation. And that's why we've had great battles millions of people have lost their lives because each society or culture wanted it my way. It used to be for land and power. It's more ideological now. But it'll come to an end soon because we've become a plague on this planet. And the ones who have the greatest desire for supremacy or their way will in fact become supreme leaders. But then that will divide in two, as life always does, because we depend on symbiosis for progress. And once that stops, we stagnate and we'll die. And these things are all obvious to us, but we're too afraid to confront them. I wake up with nightmares about this from time to time, because I know the answer, but it's unacceptable. That's the paradox. So maybe we should look towards the more difficult future, which is a metaphysical condition. But that, of course, just gets immediately shoved into the cranks and cults corner and will never be discussed seriously until it's too late. So we're caught in a difficult position. Did I say something wrong? I didn't say something wrong.